we have a special In Focus health segment for you today. Health reporter Lino Madu joins us on the phone from New York, where she's reporting on health topics being discussed at the United Nations General Assembly. Hi, Lino.
Hello, Dimyake.
So I understand that one key issue is the fight against malaria, and on Monday, a coalition of African leaders launched a program to track their progress in the fight against the deadly disease. Now, this program called the Scorecard for Accountability and Action. Tell us more about it.
Absolutely, Dimyake. Malaria is at the forefront here. Yesterday, the African Leaders Malaria Alliance, also called ALMA, launched the ALMA Scorecard for Accountability and Action, as you said. It is a tool designed to track malaria data and monitor progress in the fight against the disease. ALMA is a coalition of African heads of state and government from 40 countries that are working to end malaria-related deaths. The ultimate goal of ALMA is to reduce malaria deaths to near zero by 2015, a goal set by UN Secretary General Ban Ki-moon. The ALMA scorecard alerts leaders to progress and gaps in their country's efforts against malaria. Mm-hmm. And the idea is to prompt leaders, decision makers, as well as partners to take action to address obstacles, implement new needed policies, and ultimately save lives.
Now, you spoke with the chairman of ALMA, who is the president of Tanzania, Jakaya Kikwete. Tell us about that conversation you had with him.
Absolutely. I did an interview with President Kikwete, and he really talked about the importance of leaders to get involved in the fight against malaria. And why it was important to start ALMA is the fact that African leaders needed to come together as for a combined effort to fight against malaria and protect their citizens. He says that ultimately it is the responsibility of African leaders to keep their citizens safe, and the ALMA scorecard measures progress but inspires more action for those who need to scale up their efforts.
According to this scorecard, which countries seem to be doing very well, making a lot of progress? Is Tanzania one of them?
Well, let's say that many African countries are really, really making efforts there. You can look at the scorecard and see that many countries are really progressing. Tanzania, as you say, is definitely one of the countries. We've seen in the case of Zanzibar, where the government was able to contain malaria there. The president said that President Kikwete said that this was really a combined effort, a combined approach. We can see also that on the scorecard, it really breaks down the progress by categories, such as access to adequate treatment and long-lasting insecticide-treated bed nets, as well as policy implementation. So one other country that can be cited as an example of best practice is Rwanda. Mm-hmm. The country has been able to reduce malaria death by 60%, which is something very incredible to say. And I spoke to the Minister of Health of Rwanda. She's Dr. Agnes Binagwaho, and she said that the reason was the country was able to succeed is that they really adopted a combined approach, mm-hmm. which is country ownership. She says each country has to really own the fight against malaria and adapt it to the reality, to the realities on the ground. She says that also another reason is community help, mm-hmm. that countries really need the involvement of communities. This fight cannot be done alone without communities. And last but not least, an integrated approach. Mm-hmm. And the way she explains that is the fact that, think about a pregnant woman who goes to the hospital. Of course, you know that malaria affects pregnant women very much so, as well as children under five. So when this lady goes to the hospital, they will tell her, listen, you are pregnant, you need a bed net, but also you need to take a test, mm-hmm. for HIV. You need to get your access to prenatal care. So this integrated approach really helps in sensitizing women and population
in terms of
protecting themselves.
I can see this is right up your alley. You're fired up with all the health progress around Africa, but that's all we have time for. But you'll join us again Thursday, so we hope to hear more from you then. That's Lino Madu joining us on the phone from New York. And it's time now.